Previously on The Walking Dead.
I'm freezing.
Wait till we get up to Wellington, then talk to me about cold. Now I'm gonna go look for more wood.
Where's the rest of your group?
I'm by myself.
Bullshit!
Krista, run!
That was a gutsy move.
I'm out. Grab her. Let's go.
Would someone mind telling me what the fuck is going on here?
She's bit by a dog.
For all we know, she could be working with Carver.
So, since you're pretty much on your own, what's your plan?
Gonna eat this oatmeal?
I don't know. I'm kind of on my own now.
Well, you're welcome to stay here if you want.
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph.
Think about it. You're Carver, what do you do?
Who's Carver? You were in the woods with Krista.
Please.
Don't tell us nothing.
I'm fine. Just lost my footing. Damn it.
God damn it.
Come this way!
Damn it, you get your asses over here, both of you!
Hold that.
Nick! Hold on! Nick! God damn it! Nick!
We have to go.
This boogie. Welcome to episode 2, A House Divided. It's Kraken's Comics. We're doing a replay. And as always, TellTale Games presents. Wow, that's pretty intense. The Walking Dead. It's Deadpool's chimichanga truck.
Well, they shouldn't be able to get through that. On the downside, we can't get through them.
Dude, you got bit, right?
What are you looking at?
Staring ain't polite. Come on out and say it.
What are you going to do?
Cut it off. Yeah, let's do this.
Hand me that there.
Start this episode off right. Yep, give it to him. We're not the one that's bit. I'd have been crying like a little bit. You do it.
I'd bleed out like a stuck pig. What are you gonna do? Carry me out of here on your back?
Nope, I'll feed you to the zombies.
Just give me a minute.
Try to get some rest. There's a lot of stuff in here. I'll try to find something to help.
Alright, we can't do Pete like that. He was a good dude to us when we were in trouble. Oh, but we gave the water to the...
Anything in that?
Sorry, it's empty.
Ah, see?
Damn.
I'll keep looking around.
We gave it to the bandit who didn't give us any answers about where Krista is or what happened to her.
What's in there? Anything we can use? Give me one of those. Probably tastes like pine tar by now. But I'd smoke a dead coon's tail if you had one.
A what? Smoke them if you got them, bro. Remember, guys, when it comes to life, we're not here for a long time. We're here for a good time. So smoke them if you got them, have a drink, and enjoy yourself.
Well, that tastes about as it smells.
Now what?
We wait.
Really, that's it? It's actually a good idea to have as, like, safe houses along the way in between camps. Like, get, like, big delivery vans or trucks and just have them set up so you can sleep there at night. Or you could do my hammock idea that I had from the last episode. I think that's a pretty fresh idea. Oh, easy. Just in case. He's probably having like a nightmare.
Pete?
Oh, damn it. I feel like 10 pounds of shit in a 5-pound sack.
And subtitles just magically appeared.
Jesus. Stuck in this can the whole damn day.
You don't look so good.
You want to hear something funny? I've been thinking. And I don't want to die. I never thought I'd be the kind of idiot to say something like that. But there it is. I'm scared, Clementine. Jesus, I'm scared.
You're going to be okay.
No, you're not.
Well, at least spare me the bits. Shit.
Seriously.
Would you promise me you'll watch out for Nick? I love that stupid kid. No matter what you think, he is a good boy.
All right, whatever, man.
He's playing a tough hand, but he is a good boy.
I'll do what I can.
He's a grown-ass man.
Been almost a day. They ain't gonna find us.
Where are you going?
I'm not getting out of this. You're gonna have to make a break for it.
All right, peace.
I'll buy you some time.
Thank you, Pete.
You go find my nephew now, right?
He just argued with us.
Wait for my signal. And run straight to the woods. Just keep moving. All right. Let's get this over with.
Out of the way, Peck. Episode 2, A House Divided. Pete, we thank you for your sacrifice. they're not gonna like that I came back by myself.
Clementine, are you all right?
Nope. Luke, is Nick here?
Where's Alvin?
What happened? It's been hours. Where are they?
Clem!
We got attacked.
By who?
Walkers.
Jesus!
We all got split up. I was with Pete, but...
My God.
Where were you? Where were you exactly?
Down by the stream.
We gotta go.
Just hold on a minute.
My husband is still out there! Get the guns!
You mean your husband, who you don't know, if that's his baby?
For you.
That husband?
I told him not to go.
Damn Rebecca?
Clementine, can you please watch Sarah?
You told me to stay away from her.
Distract her, and don't tell her anything.
Just go. Hurry.
You'll be safe inside. Just don't open the doors for anything. We'll be back soon.
Don't worry about her. She'll be just fine.
Say cheese! I found this under the house. There was all kinds of old stuff.
How funny would it be if, like, Sarah pulled out, like, some weed?
Take one of me. Come on, take one of me.
Sure.
Let's humor her.
Get me in a good pose, okay? Okay, I'm ready.
That's actually a nice picture.
What's wrong?
You should change your profile.
Where's my dad? Clem, you're scaring me.
He'll be fine. Are you sure?
Yeah. He's a doctor.
Sorry, I just need to...
Oh man, you are not gonna survive this world.
You wanna see what I found?
The awkward silence.
Will you show me how to use it? I couldn't find any bullets. If something's wrong, I should know. What if I have to use one?
Yeah, you can't tell your dad. He doesn't like us as it is.
Nobody tells me anything.
As long as you don't tell your dad.
I won't, I promise.
First, remember, it's just a thing.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
I thought it'd be heavier.
That's what Lee said to her, right?
What do I do?
The most important thing is, when you go to shoot, take a breath before you pull the trigger. Not that big.
What should I shoot?
Don't do that!
Sorry. Maybe I could practice outside. There's that tree. Hey, Luke's back!
It wasn't just that long ago we were creeping through this house. Wait, that wasn't Luke. So I have some season 7 spoilers. Rumors, I guess, about the internet about who dies. If you don't want to know, or if I don't know if it's true or not. But I read something on the internet and it kind of made sense. Just a little kind of bait and switch. You know, we're going to find out who dies by Negan's hand. Mr. Negan himself. And what I read was that it was going to be Abraham. Right? He's going to get killed. But as everyone breathes a sigh of relief. Boom! It's Glenn. So we're going to get two deaths. Possibly in the season premiere of season 7. And I think that makes sense because it's just enough to kind of fool us if he kills Abraham first. And then everyone's like, oh, okay, it's Abraham. And then just 2 seconds later, just takes a swing and just brains Glenn's head in. So I don't know if you guys read that. I don't know. What do you think? Who do you think is going to die? Who do you think it's going to be? Comment. I'll be honest with you, I really don't care if Abraham dies. And it almost kind of makes sense, because if you remember in the season finale, as Negan's walking past, he kind of like sticks his chest out and kind of like challenges him. And also he was talking with Sasha about having kids in the future. And once you start trying to like think you can have a normal life and be happy in this world, that's when you die. But, you know, if Abraham dies, okay. But, you know, Glenn, he's kind of escaped death quite a few times on the show. He should have been dead a long time ago. Okay, what you say? Nobody can fit underneath the dumpster.
That's not Luke. Clem, I think I know him. He can't see me. You have to make him go away.
Who is he?
I don't remember.
No.
Clem, I can't breathe. I can't breathe.
Oh, don't answer the door.
Hello? Hello there.
Great.
Who are you?
Well, actually, I'm your neighbor.
Neighbor?
That's right. My family and I are set up a ways downriver. I'm kind of surprised we haven't run into each other yet. What's your name?
What's your name?
My name is George, honey.
Hiya, George.
Pleasure to meet you. You mind if I come in for a bit?
Yes, I do mind.
Oh, don't hit us. He's gonna slap us.
This is a nice place. Is there anyone else around? You don't usually see cabins this big out here. Sure could pack a lot of folks in there.
We have a big group. Lots.
Oh? How big?
Dozens. They'll be back soon.
And they left you here all alone?
And I have a boyfriend, and he plays football!
Well, I'll cut to the chase. I'm out looking for my people. 7 of them, to be exact.
Alright, they're dead by the river.
A long while, and I'm worried they might have gotten lost. Maybe you've seen them. A couple of farm boys and an old man. Spanish guy and his daughter. Quiet girl. Bit taller than you. Big black guy. This big. And a pretty little pregnant lady.
Alright, let's talk around with this guy.
It's a lot of people to lose.
Tell me about it. This whole damn thing's a pain in the ass.
He sounds like Gary Busey almost.
Well, looks like a damn tornado ran through here. Must be like close to 10 people with you?
More.
Hmm. Just passing through, or you been here a while?
None of your business, man.
I hope you're not one of those nuts headed up north looking for Shangri-La. Now, I'm not sure why you'd go anywhere after finding this place.
Just passing through, going north.
Whole lot of people headed that way lately. Me, I don't get it. There's just as much nothing up there as there is down here. And I can't stand that Yankee weather.
Have you been north?
Well, not since before. But I've heard things.
Aw, man.
Where does this go?
Oh, I'll take it.
This guy's playing us.
Well, it's a real nice place. Kind of cozy. I knew a guy that always wore shirts like this. Doctor. Real smug, son of a bitch. But a smart man. I miss him.
What's his name?
Carlos.
Dun dun dun.
Well, well. White's in trouble. 3 moves away from checkmate. What was that?
Squirrel.
thought you said nobody's here.
Nobody is here.
Dude, what are you, like, a Jehovah's Witness? Get out of my house.
I told you, nobody's here.
Seems that way. Didn't mean to be rude. Couldn't just leave you here with a good conscience if someone was poking around, right?
Sure.
Who's this?
Never seen her before.
You have no idea who these people are, do you?
Do you know them?
Let me ask you this. When you met them, how much did they trust you?
What's your point?
If people don't trust you, how can you trust them?
Because they're smart, Gary Busey. I don't trust you.
Well, I think I've troubled you long enough. I can let myself out.
Wait, who are you?
You have a real good day now.
Damn, we didn't get his name. I'm assuming that's Carver. Did my game just freeze? No, okay. Worst hide-and-seek player ever.
Where is he? He's gone. What if he comes back?
Maybe lock the door this time?
We need to find the others. We can't go outside.
Clementine. Sarah. They told me about Pete. You know where he is, right? Come on, let's go.
A man was here.
What?
What did she say?
Someone came to the cabin.
What?
Clementine talked to him.
And you just opened the door for him?
No.
Calm down, Rebecca.
Calm down? I am calm. You calm down.
I didn't open the door. He just came in. She's telling the truth.
Did he say his name? Did he say what his name was?
Nope.
Maybe it wasn't him.
You know damn well who it was.
Did he say his name?
Why do you care so much?
Excuse me?
I don't know why you care so much. I thought he said his name was George.
Did he?
George?
Look, Clem, just tell us what he looked like. What was he wearing? Did he sound different? How old was he?
He had a big brown coat.
Did it have a lining? A collar?
Yeah, fur. He talked about you, Dad. You're not gonna hurt anyone, are you?
Of course he won't, Sarah. Your dad's the nicest man I know, which is why he's not gonna do anything crazy.
I can't remember if he said his name was George or not.
Right?
You know these are bad people, sweetie. They will do or say anything to hurt us.
All right, what do you think? Did it seem like he'd be coming back?
He saw a picture of me.
A picture? What were you doing taking pictures?
Carlos.
What?
You need to calm down. All right, you're scaring your daughter.
You told me to distract her. Distract?
Oh, no.
So I'm just an idiot?
Yep.
We were friends.
He was scouting. We got lucky. He wasn't expecting to find us. Clementine must have surprised him. She hadn't been there. Well, he was too smart to stick around, but he'll be back with the rest. We don't have much time.
He's right. Everyone pack up. We're moving now.
Right.
Wait.
We have to leave now, sweetie, before he comes back with more bad guys. But it's gonna be okay. Let's just go get your things.
Where are we going?
Anywhere but here. Into the mountains, maybe. Clem, I don't know what he told you, but William Carver is a dangerous man. He's the leader of a camp not far from here, and he's very smart. We were lucky to escape. Look, I'm sorry to involve you, but now that he's seen you, you'll be safer with us. We have to leave.
All right, I'm with you. Let's roll. I actually don't care that Sarah's mad at us.
We'll get him on the way out, Nick.
Because we know she's not long for this world.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody grab your stuff. Let's hit the road.
I'll be surprised if Sarah's alive at... Still alive by the end of this episode.
Just up here?
Yeah, just a little ways.
Hey, Clem. Sorry if I gave you some shit back there. I'm just a little on edge. It's just a tough time right now with the pregnancy and all. You and Alvin can probably relate.
Why is Carver after you?
After me? Oh, you mean us?
Yeah.
It's a long story. He...
Don't rob a bank with this one.
Hard time letting go. I know you did your best back there. You know, none of us would make it on our own. Sometimes it's hard knowing just how dependent I am on everyone. I'm not used to that. I'm not comfortable with that. I'm supposed to be a mom soon. Guess I need to work on my patience. Alvin and I still don't know what to call her. Or him if that man gets his wish. God help me.
She doesn't even care.
Clem?
She's like, whatever, lady. How many did Pete take out?
There. That's where we were.
He's not in here.
This was the last place I saw him.
Maybe he's around here somewhere.
I was so mean to him the last time I spoke to him.
Your eyes open and stay in sight.
Anyone see him? Pete!
Oh no. Yeah, he got eaten up.
Oh my God. What happened? What the hell happened?
He's been shot.
He didn't have a gun. Who did this?
Son of a bitch.
We need to go.
He's gone. Nick, he's gone. We gotta get moving. Come on, man.
Sucks, Nick. Sorry, man.
Tell me. Tell me how it happened.
Yeah, he was bitten, man.
Scared, and...
Scared? My uncle?
He got bit. Back in the stream.
Fuck you. No way!
Nick. Come on, man.
Fuck off!
Are you gonna have a tantrum now? Child.
I'm worried about that kid. Keep an eye on him for me, would you?
That's what I told Pete.
Sure, you still want to come with us?
Look, I know we got off to a rough start, and I can't make any promises it won't get rougher, but we all know you now.
I have to look for Krista.
She was headed north, right?
Yeah.
So are we. Look, you're gonna have a better chance of finding her with us than on your own.
That's true.
I figure we got about 4 or 5 days to reach those mountains. Now, if they're tracking us, we should be able to lose them up there.
5 days?
It's gonna be okay, Beck.
We have to keep moving now. It's our only choice.
Hey, Alvin, why don't you give your pregnant wife a jacket? Jerk. 5 days later. Wait, 5 days later. Look at that movie cliche. Train bridge over a river. Let's cross it. Nothing bad is gonna happen.
See anything?
She better see something. We've been walking for a damn week.
We've got to find some shit. I just want all you millennials to know out there that all of you would be the first ones to die in the zombie apocalypse because you have no Google Maps, you don't know how to use anything but technology. You guys would be the first ones to go. I can't get a cell signal.
There's the bridge.
And does it look passable?
I think so.
Good.
Here, eat this back.
But we're almost out of food. We gotta save it.
There's a little house by the bridge.
How big is it?
It's pretty small.
Millennials be like, I can't take a selfie. This sucks.
There's a lift or something.
Chairlift? Must be that ski resort.
I've never been skiing.
Beck and I went once.
It wasn't pretty.
I'm sorry, millennials. I don't mean to diss on you.
There's a building on the mountain.
What's it look like?
It's big.
That sounds like a good place to spend the night.
We have to cross that bridge. Let's go.
Hold on now. We can't all go sprinting across that thing, okay? We get spotted out there, we're gonna be trapped.
That's true. Going around that lake will take too long.
Right, but look, we've got no idea who's out there. Okay, I'm gonna sneak across, make sure it's clear before we bring the whole group over.
You think splitting up the group is a good idea?
Well, I never said it was a good idea, but it's better than risking everyone at once.
What's your plan?
Clem and I can scoot across low and slow, make sure nobody's waiting for us on the other side.
What?
We'll have a tough time covering you from back here.
Well, we'll just turn back if it gets hairy.
Clementine should stay here. She's...
She's what?
She's just a little girl, Luke.
She's a valuable little girl. I mean, hell, if she can sew up her own arm, she's fit to cross a bridge.
I can do it.
See? No problem. It's gonna be fine. Okay, we'll signal you guys in 10 minutes. Just watch for a light at the far side.
I can go too.
You stay with the group.
I'm fine, Luke.
I don't like this.
Yeah, well, when's the last time you liked anything, Carlos?
Ah, take that, Carlos.
Come on. Hey, sorry about that. I just could really use your eyes, and right now I don't trust Nick to tie his own shoes. You're just still on edge after the Carver thing.
It's been 5 days. Why would Carver still be following us?
What's the most important thing in this world?
Family.
What does everyone want? Even the gangs. You know, what do you think they're all after?
All right, well...
Safety?
Close. Listen, what's the one thing a guy would walk hundreds of miles to get back?
All right, well, I was answering your question the first time.
Family.
It's a tough world out there without people you can trust. Anyways, You can ask Rebecca, okay? I'm not gonna get in the middle of it. We've all made mistakes. Done things that we regret. It's not my place to talk about someone else's past, you know?
Seems like we're already in the middle of it.
Tell me about it.
Does Alvin know what's going on? Alvin's like one of those people that you're like, how did he make it this far? How did he survive?
Too much noise. There are only two.
Let's take them.
I like your style.
I mean, obviously he survived because of the other people, but...
I'll take the big one.
To make it this far?
Wish we could use guns. We should be okay.
Got it. I'll take the small one.
Good. Let's do it.
Oh, we're like Tyrese with the hammer.
Go ahead. Give it a good pull. It should come free.
I know.
Shut up. I know what I'm doing.
Remember? In a shed?
Ha! Hold that.
Nice work, kid.
Ow.
I can't wait for season 3 to see how more badass this girl's become. Oh, he's got a gun. It's a cop. It's a cop and a waitress.
Shit.
Alright, there's only three of them. Let's push them over the side of the bridge. Oh!
It's okay. Clem, look. We'll figure something out. Behind you!
Oh, shit.
I love it that she curses. Oh! She almost did the Matrix. Come on, Luke, get up. Do something. The game is freezing. Oh, here it comes. Zombie kill of the week. It's right in her mouth. Sex in your mouth.
Here, give it here.
Are we good?
Thanks, Clem. Let's keep going.
Do you have your machete? Yep, he's got it. Can I have a gun, man?
You see him?
No, I don't see the guy walking down the middle of the railroad tracks.
Just play it cool. You do the talking.
What? Why me?
I don't want to get in a fight. You really think he chewed a little girl?
Yes.
Just don't make any sudden moves. And don't piss him off. And don't tell him anything.
I'd shoot me.
Well, that's a hell of a thing to say.
I'm just saying.
Well, if it comes to that, I'll shoot him first.
Well, who are you?
Well, who's asking?
I am.
Wanna help me out here?
I'm Clementine, and this is Luke.
Clementine and Luke.
Yep. We're in a band. Everyone has cool hair in this world.
Huh.
Look at this guy.
You don't look like assholes. Are you assholes? No offense or anything. but you know how it is out here. You run into a lot of assholes.
We're just people.
Fair enough. You folks headed north like everyone else?
Oh, he's got a hood on.
Everyone else?
I see at least one group a day move through here. You all look the same. It's like a great migration of the dazed and confused.
Yeah.
I gotta say, you two look like shit. If you need food, I've got some canned stuff in that station back there.
Well, cool.
That's, awful nice of you. What's the catch?
No catch. I've got plenty.
Well, all right then. Thank you.
Hey, no problem.
Did we just become best friends?
Faces out here. Like I said, I've got food and supplies back in the station. And if you want... What the fuck, man?
What the hell is he doing?
Come on, Nick. Don't... Come on, Nick.
No. He's with us. Nick! No!
Put it down!
Nick, no!
Oh, no, man. Nick, you moron.
Did I hit him? Where is he?
I told you not to shoot.
What? Who was that guy?
Why didn't you wait for a signal?
We thought you were in trouble. You were waving your arms.
He was going to help us.
How do you know?
Damn it, Nick. I told you not to shoot.
How was I supposed to hear you? You gave me a clear shot.
That shot rang out for miles. We gotta get off this bridge. Let's go.
He didn't, I mean, honestly, he didn't know, but... I mean, honestly, it's all about the group that you have on how well you're gonna survive.
Who the fuck was that back there?
I don't know.
Looked like he had a gun on you.
That asshole drew on me. He was about to shoot.
Oh, was he?
I'm telling you, man, he drew first.
Well, that's not what it looked like to me.
Everybody calm down.
What did you see, Clem? Was that guy gonna shoot?
Fuck you, Luke. You've been on my case the whole week.
And why do you think that is, Nick?
He wasn't gonna do anything.
I know what I saw.
Either way, you could have hit one of us.
Yeah, but I didn't.
Look, I know Pete was close to you, Nick, but you can't...
Don't fucking talk about him.
You think he was with Carver?
I don't know.
I mean, he did draw his gun, though.
I think so. Fell over.
He fell off the damn bridge?
We have to keep moving.
I can't. I need a minute.
Fine. Luke, can I talk to you alone?
Hey, Clem, you got anything to eat? Beck's dying here.
Alvin, I told you I'm fine.
Sorry, I'm out.
Wish we still had those juice boxes.
Yeah, me too. That man said he had food in the station.
Mind checking it out? Maybe we could spend the night here. A little small for us, though.
You could use a little downsizing.
You're one to talk.
Sure.
Thanks, Clem.
Are there any happy married people in this? I don't want to talk to Nick. I mean, then again, I mean, you don't know if that guy would have shot or not, but...
Don't see a key around here. That man probably had it.
The man, they're all empty.
Food. There's gotta be something left.
WM.
Feels pretty good.
All right, can we open the trunk with it? Yes, right? Yes. Wow, two whole cans of peaches.
Man, and I thought we had a bed. Look at this dump. Guess he did have food. Man, fuck Nick. Nick's lost a lot of his people, that's for sure. But that doesn't give him any excuse to start shooting up strangers.
He was trying to help us.
Yeah, and someone died. I ain't no judge, but that's straight up murder in my book. I mean, you ever known anyone to do a thing like that?
Actually, yeah.
What happened?
A woman in our group. Her dad died, and then she shot another guy.
Damn. What'd you do?
We left her behind.
Banished her. She shot Doug. He had his own YouTube channel.
That's funny. She looks just like you.
Hey, she looks nothing like her.
Not a lot of food here, and Rebecca, well, she's eating for two. You think we can keep this just between us? I hate to even say it, you know, but... And I'd never go against the group. But I've got to put Beck and the baby first.
The whole group should decide.
I know, you're right.
You still have your jacket on, too.
It's a shame. Nick was a good guy. He's still a good guy. He's just losing it. God knows we're not perfect. Hell, I'm glad you're with us, Clementine.
I love it how, like, all these adults are leaning on this little girl.
The hell is that?
Walkers.
We got a problem here.
Yeah, we saw it. All right, we're heading up.
Clementine, another like 4-6 weeks, you'll be running the whole group.
Well, what are we waiting for?
We have to be careful.
Careful? We've been on the road for 5 days. My back is done being careful.
Doesn't look like anybody's home. Damn. Nailed down tight. I'll check around front.
I'll go with you.
Well, it'd be good to know if anybody's actually back there. Could probably get a better view from up top. You'd have an easier time getting up there. You feel like taking a look?
It'd be just like climbing a treehouse. Yeah, just a really tall treehouse. Made of steel.
I had a treehouse once.
Well, there you go.
I hated it.
Oh.
But I'll go look, though. I don't know why she hated treehouse. It kept her safe. It's the only reason why she's still alive.
Just take it slow, and I'll catch you if you fall. Probably.
Got a good grip?
Yeah.
When I was a kid, we used to jump rooftops downtown. Now that was fun.
That sounds stupid.
Yeah. Yeah, it was. The trick was not to look down, though. Oh, you're fine. You're fine. Just look at me, okay? You're fine.
I don't look at him.
Slow down. Just for a second, okay?
Keep your voice down.
But you just yelled at me.
Shut up.
Shout out to Melissa Hutchinson. Does the voice of Clementine. Awesome job. I really appreciate voice actors. I don't think they get a lot of credit. Or enough credit. Unless you're like Troy Baker or... What's that other guy's name?
Made it.
You see anything?
I can see the bridge.
What is that? There's a car.
Wait, I see something.
What is
cars?
A light. Wait, there's another. Luke. Luke.
I wish we talked to Nick before. Gave him the business. Screwing up.
Listen, everyone, just stay calm.
Who are you? Are you trying to rob us?
Excuse me, honey, but do I look like a fucking thief?
Everyone calm down.
Hey, man, you calm the fuck down.
Sarah, get behind
just
me.
Just tell us who you are.
We ain't here to rob nobody. Put the gun down,
fuck
man.
Fuck that. Whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Please, just do what he says.
Oh, look who it is.
Kenny.
Keeney.
You know this guy?
Clementine?
Let's give him a hug, man. It's Diet Racist Kenny. And we got the music from season one.
I'll take that as a yes.
These people with you?
That'd be funny. She'd be like, nope. They locked me in his shed.
Just started dinner.
Are you sure you don't mind?
It's gonna storm soon. Please, come in.
Like, no, Kenny, they locked me in the shed. They beat me up. They're dog. Very cool. Kenny made it out alive. And he's got an awesome beard. These people are chilling.
Kenny and Sarita have been staying with us for several weeks. Used to be a ski lodge, obviously, so we have plenty of food. And believe it or not, we still get some power from that wind turbine out front. We tend to keep most of the lights off at night to avoid drawing attention. But after we found this stuff in storage, we couldn't resist making an exception. What's funny?
Oh,
your sweater.
Walter here's one smart sumbitch. Makes a mean can of beans, too.
Well, why don't you two catch up while I get some dinner started? Please, make yourselves at home. You can leave your things over there.
The hell we will.
Yeah, I'm holding on to my rifle. Thanks.
You're our guests here. There's no need to worry.
Tell him to put his gun down, then.
Kenny?
Kenny.
Vouch for these people, Clem?
Yeah.
You tell me they're good, then I'm...
Us. You were the one waving a gun around, man.
We're cool, okay? Hey, we're cool. We're cool.
Clementine?
I can't speak for everyone.
Nick.
Beck, it's their home. We're not going to find another place like this tonight.
Dad, look! A Christmas tree!
Not now, Sarah.
Isn't it great? We found it all in storage.
It's amazing.
Nick will start having some sort of flashback and
good.
Start shooting everybody.
Me, I'll show you where you can sleep.
Oh, these guys seem pretty foolish. Every window should be like boarded up. I guess the windows are up high, but.
Still wearing this dirty old thing, huh? You know, I half expected to see Lee walk up next to you. You guys were like two peas in a pod. Oh, shit, I didn't mean to... It's just hard not to think about it, you know?
He saved me.
I knew it. I knew he would. That guy had a fire in him, sure as shit. Hell. Lee and I had our differences, that's for sure. But when my son, well, he helped me do the right thing. I'll never forget that.
That he did. Yep, yep, yep.
So, where'd you end up?
I was with Krista and Omid. Omid, well, Krista and I were together for a while. But these guys caught us. She's gone.
Yeah, where is Krista?
Sounds like it ain't been easy for you. I'm sorry, darling. I wish I could have found you sooner. But everything's gonna be fine now.
Where have you been?
Oh, hell. All over after Savannah.
How did you get out of there?
For some reason, I tried to save that fucking shitbird, Ben. Then it turned into a damn cluster. Couldn't help the kid, but I got out. Long story short, I got lucky. Real lucky.
Yeah, seriously, how did you get out of the alley?
Alone after that. And then I met Sarita, thank God. Gosh, it's great to have you back.
You two catching up?
Clem, this is my girl, Sarita. Ain't she beautiful?
Nice to meet you, Clementine.
Oh, boy, Kenny.
Still out there rooting around?
Of course he is. Well, I'll start dinner.
Carlos, right?
Got himself a little Latina.
For a secret mission?
Stay in sight, sweetie.
Can we do anything to help?
Could use a hand outside. We got a lot of supplies to bring in before that storm hits.
Sure.
Clem, why don't you help Walt with dinner?
It's actually not a bad spot to hold up, especially during the winter.
Yeah, thanks.
Excellent. Want to help me prepare a little dinner? So how do you know Kenny? He and Sarita have been a huge help. Matthew and I barely knew what to do around here the first week.
It's a long story.
Connecting with people is so important. I don't know what I'd do without Matthew. Gosh, you remind me of my students. I can't imagine what it's like growing up in the middle of all this.
Keep quiet.
You poor thing.
I don't need this guy's approval with his Bill Cosby sweater.
Almost done. Would you do me the honor of tasting the first course, madam?
What is this?
Le Walter Surprise. An autumnal legume salad with a peach roux. It's peaches and beans. That's all we got.
Ugh.
Huh.
Beans.
Striking resemblance.
But she does not look like her.
From here.
Hey, give me some of that food. I want to try it. Alright, let's scope this place out. That does not look like you, Clem. Don't sweat it.
Crazy.
She's like, what is that thing?
Cousin Jared's concert, October 13th, 1998.
Put on some music. You got some Public Enemy?
School.
I don't care about the Christmas tree. Don't ask me to help either.
Some help. Here, Sarah, you take this and string them up over there. You knew Kenny before. It must be incredible to see him again. When I met him, well, he's so different now. But you must be so glad.
So, how'd you meet Kenny?
I found him holed up in an old restaurant, if you can believe it.
Holed up?
You should have seen his beard then. Perfect. Now we just need the topper.
We always had an angel on top of our tree.
My family didn't celebrate Christmas. But I still love the decorations.
Alright, is she Spanish? She definitely got an accent. Sarita. Sarita. Find a tree topper. Let's get a can of peaches and put it up there. The video game Invisible Wall. One pond went to. It looks like a small mountain. But it is a good place to hold up because, like, when it snows, how are the walkers going to get up there? Take them a while.
It's crazy. Why would they follow us this far?
We can't be sure.
It's been a week, man. We gotta be out of the woods.
We can't be sure. They might be tracking us.
Tracking? Who do you think they are? Ninjas?
Clem, Luke said you saw some people in the valley.
People? Way down there. How?
She's got binoculars, genius.
I saw lights.
Which way did they go?
Back into the woods.
We cannot take any chances. We leave at dawn.
But we're safe here for tonight, right?
Clementine, you talked to that man Walter, right? What did he say? You didn't tell him anything about us, did you? We have to be careful. They could be hiding something.
We mostly talked about Kenny.
Kenny is the loud man with the beard?
Yeah, that's him.
Look, I don't care what that man said. We're staying here tonight.
Just talk to the rest of them. They trust you. See what you can find out. I'm gonna go find Luke.
Honey, I don't feel so good.
Beck, what's wrong?
I just need something to drink.
You got it. I'll be right back.
She might be sick because you didn't give her your jacket. There we go. Alright, so I get the angel so we can appease Sarah.
She looks so cool.
Beautiful. I used to love this time of year. You know, now that your friends are here, this place is starting to feel like a real home. Matthew and Walter are amazing people. Honestly, it's dangerous to be this kind, but they can't help it. Wait until you meet Matthew. He's a real character. The first time he met me, he called me Rita. So I call him Maddie now.
What does Matthew look like?
Yeah.
He's a handsome man. Little shorter than Walter. He should be back soon.
Do you have a brown jacket with fur?
Clem, I wanted to ask you, does Kenny seem different to you? I didn't know him before, and, well, I'm curious. He has good days and bad days like everyone else. But lately I get the feeling he's struggling.
I haven't noticed.
Well, I've been here like 10 minutes.
Well, let me know if you do.
Well, you three have been busy.
Kenny, isn't it great?
I got it, huh?
I think I can manage, Ken.
I said I got it.
Oh, there's the old Kenny. Old hot-headed.
To play the gentleman, but I'll tell you, when I met him, he couldn't lift a fly. Why don't you go see if your friends are ready for dinner, Clementine?
You're a little old for a nose ring, aren't you? Let's talk to Rebecca.
Are you okay?
Just got a little dizzy. I can't even take care of myself. How am I supposed to raise a child? I mean, how can anyone now?
It's not gonna be easy.
Everyone has cool hair in this game. Look.
It's hard. But at the same time, I already feel a little less lonely. Because I know that no matter what happens, I'll get to meet someone new. She's kicking. Wanna listen? That food smells good, huh? It's okay. We're gonna get you something soon.
Can I?
Let's see if it'll make her feel better.
She's gonna be a runner.
She better be. A little zombie she gotta run away from.
Not his.
All right.
Whose is it then?
Let's get down to nitty gritty.
If Alvin finds out, he'll kill me. I don't know what to do.
Wait, whose is it?
I can't believe I'm asking a little girl for advice. But I
guess these adults are the worst.
I wouldn't say anything.
There's my man.
You all right, baby?
I'm fine, you big dope.
Just need to get some food in you. Thanks for staying with her, Clem.
I bet you Alan's like one of those gentle bears.
Dinner is served.
Peaches and beans.
You okay, man?
Yeah, just... I wish I hadn't pulled that trigger.
Just try to forget about it.
Right here, Clem.
I don't understand why this is such a big deal. It's like high school cafeteria. But we haven't seen Kenny in a while. So we want to catch up with him, right? I don't know why that would be a problem.
Here you go, Clem.
So, Clem, we were just talking. What's the deal with the kid? And what's his name? Luke? He in charge? You trust him?
Okay, one question at a time.
Kenny, please.
Sarita, we don't know these folks.
They seem nice.
Yeah, well, gators seem nice, too, till they bite your damn arm off.
Kenny!
I like him. He's a good guy.
Would you trust him with your life?
I think so.
Save me.
That guy, Big Al, he said they were on the run.
Some people are after them.
Well, you don't have to worry about that no more. They'll go tomorrow and you can stay here.
Absolutely. Honey, you stay with us as long as you want.
She's staying for good.
What about Krista?
Of course she does. Right, Clem?
Not what I want. Gotta find Krista.
Hey there.
Hey.
Hope you like the food.
Oh, it's great. Thank you.
Peaches and beans. Great for nutrition. Not too great on the way out, though, I tell ya. So, it's Luke and Nick. Luke and Nick. You guys sure do look like a match.
What's that supposed to mean?
Uh-oh.
I'm just saying you look like good friends, that's all.
So, what was your plan here? Hold out for the winter?
Actually, we were thinking of moving on. Somewhere up north. You ever heard of a place called Wellington?
Wellington? The hell is that?
A place.
What kind of place?
A good one, Einstein.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Krista and I were going there.
Supposed to be a big camp up near Michigan.
Michigan?
You got a hearing problem, kid? Yeah, Michigan. Think about it. Fresh water, lots of land, and cold-ass winters so the walkers get slow.
Sounds like bullshit.
Listen, Vanilla Ice, I don't know what your deal is, but you're more than welcome to take off in the morning.
That'd be just fine by me.
What's the deal with these guys, Clem?
Hey, fuck you, buddy.
It's fine, Nick. We're not staying.
She's staying.
What? Excuse me?
You heard me.
Please, don't fight.
Gentlemen, please. There's no need for this.
Shut up, Bill Cosby.
We've all had a long day. Please eat.
Pass me that can, Duck.
Duck? Who's Duck?
Duck was his son.
Was. Get it, Luke?
Hey, Clementine, would you lend me a hand outside for a moment? I'm sorry about that. You know, I used to be a teacher, and I remember what it's like to be caught in the middle of two cliques. I suspect they'll find common ground soon enough. It may take a little time, but that's just how these things work. Everything will be fine.
Listen, relationships are like any machine. You don't throw them out when they break down. You get your hands dirty and you grease the wheels.
Shut up.
Will you help me work on them?
We're gonna leave in the morning.
No, you gotta stay.
We have to keep moving.
Clementine, in this world, you don't have to do anything. They say the world is over, but I'll tell you a secret. It's not. People are more political now than they ever were before. In the end, we can't change the world. All we can do is continue to learn from each other, to empathize and use our heads. All war is a symptom of man's failure as a thinking animal. Steinbeck. Have you read him?
What?
Well, we have plenty of time to catch you up on your reading. My partner Matthew is amassing quite the literature collection. I think you'll like him. In any case, the point is, as long as we have our wits about us, we can always make the right choice. Right?
Sure. Right. And the more you know, and knowing is half the battle.
Is there something you want to tell me? You can talk to me, Clem. There's almost nothing you could tell me that would surprise me. I can promise you that.
I don't know why I chose to stay quiet, but...
Hey, kids, what are you two talking about?
Oh, politics.
The hell?
Well, being from Florida, I would imagine you know all about politics, Kenny.
Man, I know one advantage of living in the apocalypse is not dealing with that shit no more. I was just gonna check the windows round back before this storm hits. Give us a hand?
Sure.
Is that Bonnie?
Miss?
Bonnie from 400 Days, is that you?
Do you have any food?
Are you okay?
I saw the house and I have a family. We're starving. We live down there.
Of course. Why don't you come in, Miss...
Bonnie.
Walt, I don't know. You're just gonna let her in like that?
It's fine, Kenny.
We don't know this girl.
Then we'll have to get to know her. Right, Clem?
Walt.
How much damage can this poor woman do?
A lot. She's a crackhead.
Check her for weapons.
Yeah.
Thank you. Really, but that storm will be on us soon, and I gotta get back to my family.
I'll bring something out to you, then.
You don't have to do that.
No, it's fine.
What about your people?
We've got plenty. You stay put. I'll be right back.
Out of all the people from the group from 400 Days, she's the last person I want to see.
A girl like you. How old are you, sweetie?
Take your food and go. Where's Russell?
Here you are, miss.
This is too much.
Don't mention it.
I don't know how to thank you.
Just help someone else down the line.
Thank you so much. I'll be going now.
You stay safe.
You too.
Clem, go on inside and get to bed. Walt and I gotta talk for a second.
Tell me to go to bed. It's the zombie apocalypse. Go to bed whenever I want.
Clementine. Don't freak out.
What's up, Luke? Being all sketchy.
Listen. Okay, I gotta tell you something. That guy on the bridge was Walter's friend.
Oh, that's Matthew. It was so obvious.
See, I knew something was off, so I asked Sarita about their friend. Now they're all worried he's not back yet.
Where's Nick?
I don't know. I don't think Walter knows yet, so we have to keep this quiet. I mean, who knows what the hell he'd do if he found out?
He'd kill us.
What if he finds out anyway?
Well, then we're fucked. But, you know, we'll just deal with it then. Now, do you still have that knife? Because if it was Matthews and Walter sees it, he's gonna put two and two together.
It's with the other weapons.
Okay, well, go get rid of it. and I'll find Walter and run interference. Oh, and, keep an eye out for Nick.
I'm right here. What's up?
Nothing.
Oh, there's nothing, man. I just wanted to check and see if you're okay.
Nothing.
Hey, if there's something going on, I want to know.
No. Ooh. Just go back to bed, Nick.
I'm serious. You guys can talk to me.
I know.
No. No, we can't.
Trust me now?
It's nothing, really. Forget it.
Look, Clem, just go do that thing, all right? Come on, Nick. Let's go find a beer or something.
I mean, it is pretty obvious that guy was Matthew, but, like, why was he down here by himself? Oh, stuff is gone.
It's gone.
It's gone. The evil is gone from here. Well, there goes that. The knife had the initials WM, right? Walter Matthew. Bill Cosby is going to go full eight.
Walter?
Are you smoking?
I like this knife. Gave it to Matthew when all this started. I know he's dead. Who did it? Was it that kid? What's his name? Nick?
Yep.
Heard him talking earlier, something about shooting a man. I could see it. See it on his face. Wasn't sure then. But now?
It was our fault.
So we're cool, right, hippie? Jesus.
I don't feel good.
Nick shot him.
This guy's probably a serial killer.
Is Nick a good man? Or is he just like everyone else? Is he just one of those fuckers that don't give a shit about anyone but themselves?
Nah, he's a good guy.
He's a good guy, Walter.
He's an idiot, but...
He was always going out alone. I told him something like this would happen, but he wouldn't listen. No, Matt always knew best. What's going on?
Shut up.
You need to tell him.
Tell him what?
What happened on the bridge?
Put the knife away, bud.
Tell me what you did. Just tell me, son. Tell me what happened.
From a distance, it looked like anyone. I thought he was going to shoot my friends, and I shot Matthew. But it happened real fast. I didn't know if I hit him, but I did, and I didn't mean to.
Do you know what you've done to me? Do you have any idea?
I didn't mean to. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Walter.
Nick, run. Nick, run. Now give me a hug.
Walt, what's going on? The storm's got it spinning out of control. That sound's gonna draw walkers. We gotta shut it down now.
Nick, help me. Carry the guns.
Gun?
Yeah. You're on the top of a mountain.
That thing's a damn dinner bell.
Hasn't been on this whole time?
What the hell was that? Damn it! Transformer must have gone. Gotta check it. I could use a hand.
I'll go with you.
I'm going to.
No! It's too dangerous. The rest of you, get this thing shut down.
Is Is it really that much louder because it's spinning so fast?
Does anyone know how to do this? Great.
I can do it.
Okay, we'll watch your back. Nick, scan the trees with me.
All right, what do we got here?
It's too dark.
Some keys. Seems too obvious, but... Okay, so easy, a 9-year-old can do it. Not the grown adults, though. Because they don't believe in magic, so that's why they can't turn off the windmill.
Yeah.
We don't have much ammunition.
We gotta get back to the lodge.
So run!
They're behind us!
Alright, Clementine, you had a gun. Where is it? Oh, wait! Whoa, whoa! I was like, how did I miss it? Like a surgeon with this, Jake.
Run, go.
Thanks, Carlos. Quick, 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 quick. Oh. It's got a little kick to it. Just like in the movies. Nice shot. Told you he was a serial killer.
Clem, get inside! Go!
Clementine, are you okay?
Oh, who's got a machine gun? We're definitely in trouble. Oh, Bonnie.
Howdy, folks.
It's Gary Busey.
Where's Rebecca?
Carver.
It's nice to see you, too.
Sarah!
Got rocked.
Inside. It's you.
Keep moving.
So is that where the group for 400 days ended up? The Carver's group? Or did Bonnie just end up there?
I don't remember.
Look at this place.
Foxtrot Bravo. We are weapons hot, over.
A lot of windows. It's fucking huge. Bill's gonna hate it. Now the rest of them could be anywhere.
Man, how the fuck are we gonna cover these guys and look for them too?
Johnny, cover that window.
At least we treated it decent. Maybe that'll count for something. Oh, where's Kenny? Kenny's gonna come in guns blazing. Tell this guy's smart, knows what he's doing.
Listen, I'm only gonna ask you once. Where's Rebecca?
Sarah, look at me. It's gonna be okay.
Rebecca! Rebecca! Our baby deserves to be raised in a place of safety.
I know you're out there. Melvin, Luke, and the girl. This is real simple. You want this over quick. You all play nice. And show your faces.
My dad, please.
He'll kill him.
No, Melvin.
We gotta go down there.
I can't do that.
But he's a doctor. Can't kill him.
You need a doctor.
No. Where's Luke and Kenny?
How the hell am I supposed to know?
They're still outside. They can help us.
We have to help Carlos.
Only way to help him is to do what the man says.
What about Luke and Kenny?
Look at those guns. If he starts shooting, and people are going to die on both sides.
Oh!
Clem can sneak out. Find Luke.
What the hell is she going to do? And you heard him. Carver knows she's with us.
Just stop! Don't hurt my dad, please!
We're going down there.
He'll kill you.
Fuck you.
He will.
Somebody just shoot him!
Clem, go get help.
He'll kill him, Beck.
He'll do it anyway.
You don't know that.
Say goodbye, Carlos.
Don't look, Susie.
Oh.
Dad.
Yeah, we gotta give up, right?
Well, that's disappointing.
He's gonna kill him. Rebecca, we have to give up.
Where are you gonna go?
Stop!
If he would have killed him anyway.
You alright?
Fuck you, Bill.
You don't want to do this. Please, let these people go.
Just shut up.
Clem, can you reach my hands?
Everything under control?
Clem.
Yeah. Alright, what's up? What are we trying to do? Oh!
Don't move.
Peekaboo.
I can't see him.
Watch them.
Oh!
No!
Straight executed him.
Now, I didn't want to do this. But you ain't leaving me much choice.
And I'm Gary Busey, and I'm crazy.
I'm gonna march another one of your friends out here, and I'm gonna put a bullet in the back of their head. Or you can give up now. Your choice.
All right, take Nick. Take Nick.
You motherfucker.
Alvin!
Bill, no! Tell him to stop! Kenny, stop!
You remember George, Alvin? You see, I do. I remember a guy that was your friend named George. I remember when you murdered him in cold blood. And why? Because you didn't like me? You could have lodged a complaint. You could have been civil.
Bill, no! We'll do whatever you want!
I love you, Beck.
Bill, please!
Kenny! Luke! Don't shoot!
Oh, whoops. We had to open our mouth. I would like to see if what gone on with this group before.
We can do this all night. Is that what you want? Where's Luke?
He's on Dagobah somewhere?
Why am I not surprised? I warned you. I warned you not to follow him. Look where he's led you. But you're safe now. We're going home. As a family.
This guy's crazy. I can't believe Alvin's still alive.
Alright, round him up. We're heading back to camp.
We're in trouble, Clem. All right, well, at least Luke's still out there.
I don't know if we could have saved Walt, but I know one of us didn't just give up.
Yeah, I know. Folks are sore over what happened. But let's remember, these are our brothers and sisters, and they all have a vital role to play in this community.
Blah, 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 blah.
They strayed from the flock, yeah. That don't mean they can't earn their way back into the fold. That don't mean we can't find it in our hearts to forgive them. Knowing full well, those who choose not to accept our love surely wish that they had.
The storm is on the way.
Braca Doom, and there it is. Episode 2, A House Divided. Way better than the first episode of Season 2, All That Remains. I feel like the choices had a little bit more consequences and, like, I was kind of struggling with them. I really don't remember my first playthrough too bad. I forget Walter gets totally executed like that. But anyway, let's see what my choices were. Friendship. Did we take the blame for Sarah's photo? You and 50% of players blamed somebody else. We did? I thought we took blame. Oh no, we said we were going to distract her. Whatever. That didn't mean anything. Who did you sit with at dinner? 61.6% of us sat with Kenny. Why was that a big deal? You know, I was in high school. I hadn't seen Kenny in a while, trying to figure out what's been going on with him. But honesty, we told Walter the truth about Matthew. You and 54.7% of players told Walter the truth. I kind of think he already knew. We just magically show up on his front doorstep. Walter is nowhere to be found. He would have figured it out, I think. And forgiveness, Nick's fate. You and 57.7% of players convinced Walter to forgive Nick. Hey man, that guy's a hippie. I'm glad we did. I thought Nick was going to get the knife right in the gut. And bravery, we left to find Kenny. You and 54.2% of players stayed to help Carlos. Carlos is a doctor. We need him for Rebecca's baby. Yeah, that one's 50-50. Again, much better than the first episode. Little surprises here and there. Matthew, Nick being loose cannon, Pete going out, sacrificing himself for us. I enjoyed this episode. Getting ready for episode 3 next time on Krakens Comics.